We're ready to go.
Okay.
Now, like a lot of people that work on little engines, I do spend my fair share of time on Craigslist looking for things I can rebuild. And every now and again, you come across something where you just sort of look at it and stare at it and say, huh. Now, I saw this, and I was pretty impressed by it. Somebody spent a lot of time putting this thing together. If you look closely at it, it's got a wood panel deck, along with a steel frame around the outside that it looks like he spent some time on. He put handcart wheels on the front and left a spot in the back that you can put a cooler in. And if that's not the perfect accessory for a mower, I don't know what is. Now in the ad, he's only asking for $20 for it, and he does say it needs some help. It starts, but it smokes. So you got to give him credit for honesty. So let's move on to the next one. If you spend enough time online looking for equipment, you'll see the term excellent is used pretty liberally. Here's a good example. A lawnmower that says it's missing a cover and it just has piles of garbage on it, and it's pretty rough looking. But in the ad, it says it's in excellent condition. Or this great looking edger. It's sitting in a corner, completely covered in dirt, obviously forgotten. And the first word in the ad is excellent. But if you look at it, it obviously doesn't need a new blade yet. It's bound to last another week or two. Now let's move over to this vacuum and chipper N1. It says it's in great shape and it does run, and the condition is excellent. Now, if you look a little bit closer, it looks like it collects most of the dirt on the outside of the machine, not the inside, and it obviously hasn't been cleaned up in a long time. Maybe I'm just confused about the term excellent. I'm telling you, people, you're killing me.